What is machine learning and how you can use it in your business or projects? In this video, I'll walk you through key concepts of machine learning without using code or maths. Machine learning is everywhere. You may not have noticed, but machine learning is all around you. When you read your emails, you don't see spam because machine learning filters them out for you. When you type a query in Google, this is how Google recommends which results to show. When you receive a book recommendation by Amazon, or a movie recommendation by Netflix, it is machine learning at play. Your Facebook and Instagram feeds are curated using machine learning. ML, or machine learning for short, is responsible for automatically approving or declining credit card transactions and continuously monitoring accounts for the sign of fraud. Whenever you use a computer, chances are machine learning is involved somewhere. So, what is machine learning? Once upon a time, when we wanted the computer to perform some task, we needed to provide it with a detailed set of instructions. That is a program. Computers then often follow those instructions to execute the task at hand. For all different tasks, we need to write a separate program. Machine learning is different. In case of machine learning, we don't need to provide instructions to computers. Computers program themselves. They look at the data and draw inferences from them. The more data they have, the better they get. No one programs your taste into Amazon recommendation engine. It learns to figure out themselves by inferring from your past purchase data. Tesla's self-driving car taught itself how to stay on the road. No programmer wrote an instruction for it. ML is something new under the sun, a technology that builds itself. Machine learning is a process in which the computer learns to solve a problem and make a decision like humans. Humans make decisions based on intuition, which is based on experience. In case of ML, computer learns to make decisions based on experience and data rather than instructions. Simply, ML is all about teaching computers how to think like humans. Humans make a decision in two ways, either by logic and reasoning or by experience. How humans make a decision and how computers do the same. Similar to humans, machine can also be taught to make decisions in two different mentioned ways. In short, when we talk about machines making a decision using both one and two ways, it is called AI. And when a computer focuses on only the second way, it falls under machine learning. In this case of computers, experience equates to data. So by this logic, machine learning is a subset of a broader field called AI. In order to understand how machine can make a decision using data, let's first try and understand how humans make a decision based on experience. We humans use remember, model, and predict framework to make decisions. Let me explain. First, we remember our experiences and situations we went through in our life. Second, based on the experience, we formulate models to generalize the concept. We can then use those models to predict what is likely to happen in a particular situation. For example, if the question is, will India win the match against Bangladesh today? We will evaluate this question using remember model predict framework. We remember India won most of the matches against Bangladesh in last 2 years. We model that Indian team is stronger compared to Bangladeshi team. Hence, India is likely to win the match today. There are chances that we may be wrong in our prediction, but this is the method we use to make our decision. Doing prediction for computers could be challenging, as all they do is store some numbers and do operations on them. Programming them to mimic human level of thought is challenging. Following the remember model predict framework, it is clear to see that remember for machines stands for data. So what is data? Data is simply information. Anytime we have table with information, it is data. Normally in a table, each row is a data point. For example, if we have a data set of fruits, then in this case, each row represents a different fruit. Each fruit is described by certain features through columns. In our fruits data set example, features could be color, size, and shape. Features describes the data. Some features are special and we call them labels. Labels depends upon the context of the problem we are trying to solve. For example, if we are trying to predict the type of fruit from the given data, then the type of fruit is a label. For the purpose of machine learning, data comes in two flavors, labeled data and unlabeled data. When the data comes with a label attached to it, it is called labeled data. And similarly, when the data does not have a label attached to it, it is called unlabeled data. So in this example, when we are marking fruits by the name, it is a labeled data. And in the case we don't have labeled it, it is unlabeled data. Better the quality and quantity of data will be, predictions will be better. But before we get into prediction, let's explore what models are. Machine learning models can be broadly categorized into three different types: supervised learning, unsupervised learning, and reinforcement learning. Supervised learning is the most natural way to start on your machine learning journey. They take labeled data as an input. Supervised learning is most commonly used in ML tasks. Supervised learning models take labeled data as an input. Data is labeled such that based on the prediction we wish to make from the models. Let me explain this with an example. Recalling our fruit dataset, if we feed the data into a supervised learning model with labels apples and grapes, the model will then use the fed data to predict if a new data is apple or a grape. This means when we bring a new image of a fruit, it can predict whether the new image is that of an apple or grape. Recall the human decision-making framework, remember, model, and predict. This is precisely how the supervised learning models work. The model first remembers the data we feed into it, then it makes rules or models what A and B looks like, and finally predict the same for the new image. Labeled data comes in two types. Data can be labeled with a number such as weight or weight of a fruit, or data can be labeled as classes such as apple, oranges, banana. Based on the type of data, there are two types of supervised learning models. Regression models. These are the models which can predict number as an output. And classification models. These are the models which can predict the class as an output. Note that output of a regression model is a continuous variable, while the output of a classification model is discrete variable, since it can predict from finite number of set of outputs. Let's take a few examples to understand them better. Regression models are designed to predict numbers. These numbers are predicted from features. It may include predicting a house price based on features of house such as number of bedroom, locations, etc. Predicting the expected duration a user will use the website based on source of traffic, etc. Or predicting the lifetime value of a customer or amount a customer is expected to pay based on the features such as customer type, consumption level, etc. Predicting the price of a particular stock based on other market signals or company-specific feature in stock prices. As you may notice, the result of such prediction is expected to be a number. On the other hand, classification models predict a class. They help us answer questions such as looking at a picture, which fruit it is, apple or orange. Examples may include image recognition, such as predict the content of an image, if there is an airplane in the picture or not. User behavior. Predict if the user will click on an ad, add to cart button based on the user's historical browsing history with an output yes or no. Social media. Will the user like a picture or post based on their demographic, history, and friends? Now you know how Facebook shows you the post which you are expected to engage with. Unsupervised model take unlabeled data as an input, which means the data does not have any labels but only features. So, for example, the housing data set which does not have prices but only details such as room size, location, etc. The obvious question is then, what you can do from such data? Well, it is true that unlabeled data has limited use, but we can still achieve some insights from them which may be useful. For example, if we have a set of pictures of different fruits without labels, can we use unsupervised models to break them into groups such as pictures of apples, oranges, etc.? This is called clustering, a task of grouping data into clusters based on similarity. Examples of clustering include genetics, clustering species into groups based on similarity, or in market segmentation, grouping customers into different segments based on features such as company size, number of employees, etc. Let's look at a data table below. Grouping the data set is called clustering. So in this case, we are grouping the rows to create clusters. How about grouping the feature side or the column? Well, it is called dimensionally reduction. It is very useful data pre-processing step which is used to simplify the data before it is fed into the models. Examples of dimensionally reduction could be, in case we have this five data: length, height, breadth, mileage, and power. This could be reduced to just two dimensions by understanding length, height, and breadth as a size and mileage and power as efficiency. And finally, there's a third type of machine. Reinforcement learning models solves a problem without any data. Instead of data, they are provided with an environment and an agent. The agent is then expected to navigate within the environment. The agent may have a goal or set of goals. On taking the right decision to reach the goal, the agent is rewarded, and on taking the wrong decision, it is punished. Hence, the learning is reinforced on it. In case of reinforcement learning, an agent needs to take a sequence of actions within some environment. This action influences the information that the environment provides to the agent in the next step. The agent receives direct feedback on the action it takes. In supervised or unsupervised learning, in contrast, the model never impacts the underlying data. It simply consumes it. For example, let's assume that the agent is driving the car and its goal is to take the car from some point A to B. The action the agent can take could be steering, accelerating, or pressing the brakes. The environment in this case is the real world, consisting of roads, traffic, pedestrians, etc. The reward in this case is every meter the car travels towards the destination, and the punishment would be minor, such as traffic infractions, or major in case of collision. Reinforcement learning has cutting-edge applications, such as self-driving cars. Here, the agent is expected to plan the route, control the car, keep the car on the track, etc. Industrial robotics. Here, the agent task is to learn how to pick a box, how to walk or handle any particular task in manufacturing process. Agents need to learn how to play chess, could be an example from gaming. I hope you will be able to use some of these methods in your business and process after getting the concepts of machine learning. I hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like it and subscribe to our channel for weekly updates.